brand new. Loving you is the easy part. Loving you is so. Loving you is the easy part. Loving you is so. Is so. Is so. Is so. Is so. Is so. Loving you is the easy part. Loving you is so.
Hello, hello, hello. Hi, everyone. Welcome to today's Peaceful Craft Time live stream. We're here every Sunday, 3 p.m. Eastern. So glad you could tune in. Today, we're going to be doing some bullet journaling. This has kind of been like ruminating in the background as a possible topic for Peaceful Craft Time. So I thought we would do that today. If you would like to, wait, let me just get this set up here. Hang on one second. Oh, yeah. Okay, so this is my bullet journal, and I'll give you an intro to my bullet journal that I use. I've been bullet journaling for maybe 3-4 years now. I kind of have lost track of how long. These are past bullet journals, and I can kind of compare and contrast for you if you need any info on that. I got my stationery, pens, I got my stickers, and then I have a few more things in this basket over here that I'll bring out once we get started. But yeah, we're just gonna have some time doing some bullet journaling, and whatever it is that you're doing right now, whether you want to relax with some arts and crafts, Peaceful Craft Time is very open-ended. You can do some cleaning, feel free to do some cooking, whatever you like. There is a background music that is available in the description if you want to pop that open. I have been guilty of only having like one link for the past couple of live streams, but I updated it. Now there's like 3 different options, kind of like ranging between chill hop and jazz, and one of them even has some rain. So feel free to give those a try to see what it's like. Today in Toronto, it's super sunny, super warm, so I have to admit I'm not quite in the mood for rain, but if you're, you know, feeling that the precipitation could help you relax and chill out, feel free to click that. What else is there to go through? Oh yeah, so we've been doing these Peaceful Craft Times as fundraisers, so if you want to use the donation feature, I see that someone has already donated, which is so sweet. You can do so. It obviously, there's no pressure. I just put it there to kind of remind us that as we're having our own time at home trying to take care of the health of our community, that if you want, there are ways that you can give to the people who are on the front line, who are working hard to keep us all safe. So there's that option. All of the proceeds will go to global relief efforts. You don't have to donate to this charity, but whichever one, local or international, that interests you, feel free to do so. And there's been a lot of compliments on these cute little graphics. I have to give credit to my graphic designer, Michelle Choi. She did such a great job putting these together. So if you love the little intro video of me sewing or these graphics, give some love to Michelle. She'll really appreciate it. And in the future, if you guys want to be aware of when these live streams are happening every Sunday, you can subscribe if you want to. You can hit the bell notification so you're notified every time we go live. And I think that is it for all of my housekeeping stuff. Let's get started. I'm just reaching over here because this is my little like command center in case you're wondering what that is all about. Thank you all for saying hi in the comments. Yeah, let me know if you're working on any projects or whatnot. You can also ask questions. I have the comments right here for me to view, so I'll try my best to keep an eye out for the questions that you're asking. I'm really sorry if I miss them, and if you really want me to answer, feel free to keep asking it, and hopefully I'll catch it. Also, my assistant Julia is in the comments, moderating and helping to respond to questions too, so feel free to say hi to Julia. She's a really, really great person, and she's doing a great job. Okay, let's get started with bullet journaling. So, if you're a longtime viewer of my channel, you know that I've been bullet journaling for quite some time. So this is the current edition that I'm on right now. Oh, I gotta make sure you guys can see that. Okay, this is the current edition that I'm on right now, and let me know if you need me to like zoom in or anything, because yeah, I know it can feel a little small. So this right here is a Statlogy. I switched to this one. So like for a very long time I was on the Moleskine, and I really liked that I was consistently using these because I had this dream that they would all fit neatly on a shelf like some chronology of diaries and whatnot. So I was using the Moleskine. This one has the grid dot layout, so the grid dot helps make it a little bit easier for you to organize your rows and columns, but then it's faint enough that you have the freedom to do some drawings or whatnot. Oh, I managed to open this to a very great example page. And back when I was working with this book, I was like learning a lot of calligraphy and whatnot, so I was also using it as a space to just like get my practice on. I practiced writing the word day a lot because Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, my day got really good, and the rest was, it was variable, we'll say. And then I kind of filled the rest of the space with stickers. I'm not crazy for doodling, simply because I do need my bullet journal to kind of be like a certain level of efficient for me, and doodling can take a little bit too long. Plus, I don't know, I might not be that good at it. So I had this Moleskine for a really long time, and then after I was done that Moleskine, I switched over to, I also apologize in advance if I'm saying these words wrong. I also switched over to this notebook by Shinola Detroit, and this one was gifted to me by my best friend.
When you're presenting on that side.
They can't see it? Okay, sorry,
so
Dan.
Present below the
okay, camera. Dan's giving me a tip that they can't. I'm so sorry, you guys. Okay, I'll switch this way. So, if there is a Shinola Detroit store near you, unfortunately the one that's near me I think actually just closed, you can get a special feature where they do some embossing onto the front cover. So when my best friend gave this to me, she got it embossed with Wendy, which is super, super sweet of her. So yeah, I really treasure this because it's got my name on it. And this one is completely blank. So for a while I was just going like free for all. These aren't doodles, these are just really pretty stickers. And it just kind of let me treat every page with whatever I needed it to do for me. Maybe because this was too freeform that I ended up switching to a grid, which is what this Statlogy notebook has. So this one also size-wise, let me show you a comparison. It is ever so slightly wider, which kind of gives me just like a little bit more room to organize things. I don't mind that. Regrets is that it is a softer cover, so I do have to be a little bit more careful. It won't withstand as much of a beating if I like toss it into my bag as the Shinola or the Moleskine, obviously. That's one regret. Another regret is the lack of ribbon that helps hold it all together, because that's another feature that helps these to last longer and be like safely bound up. But I don't know, maybe I had the foresight that I would just be home a lot and I wasn't too concerned about those compromises. All right, so here's the Statlogy notebook and the grid that it has. I'll try to bring it up closer to the camera for you to see. It's just a faint little grid. Oh yeah, you can see it. They've got a faint little grid. They've got little numbers running along the side so that you don't have to count all of the different number of square rows. And then at the very top, I mean, this is like so tiny that it's almost not useful, but it's there. They have a little like January, February, the months, the day of the week, the date. I don't use this feature very much because it's just so small. Like, it almost would be better, maybe, if it wasn't there. Even online, I've seen people mention in the reviews that it's not the best. But the main thing that I use this for is making my weekly spreads. So in this, I will do a format where it's like, I do Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and that way it helps me a lot because I can see my whole week in advance, and then I'll break it down by the hour to help me try to treat my tasks as little chunks so that they're not as intimidating as a larger project. So I'll show you how I do that setup. I really truly do this every Sunday, so this timing is perfect. It's how I get ready for the week, and I purposefully don't schedule my Saturdays and Sundays simply because that's a time I try to be in like a restful mindset. All right, I'm gonna get started with a blank page. And then I see in the comments, I apologize from when I was holding up the notebooks earlier. I'll run through that again real quick. Number one, Moleskine. This one is from, let's see what the date is on the first page. Oh goodness, January 2017. And this one was the one where, this notebook was the one where I got started with bullet journaling and adapted it. So yeah, I've been bullet journaling for over three years, according to this. And I have a whole video that goes through how I got into it, because I know online, I guess my perception of how bullet journal videos were going was there were so many that gave you like inspo for doodling and all that kind of stuff. And I just thought there might be people who are more like me out there who are intimidated by all the doodles and just want to get started with like making their life a little bit more organized or efficient. So the way that I got started with that, and I go into more detail in that beginner bullet journal video, is I restricted myself to only using one pen. It was a different pen back then, but similar to just like a thin black pen. This is the one I use now for Muji. Back then, I think I was using the Sharpie black pen. When you restrict yourself to just one pen, it helps you to not feel like, I have to use every pen, it has to be full of colors, I got a highlight, got a star, got all that. Like, one pen helps you focus just on the pragmatism of what's going on. So I started with like a to-do list. Back then there were a few things that I was planning on buying as part of like getting into some New Year's resolutions and whatnot. So I had a buy list, and then here I just wrote some of my thoughts. Here I wrote some reflections. I wrote like a little timeline of the day. I made a work plan, and like truly from just this one page alone, I could tell which features I found the most useful, which features I didn't like as much. And so by the time I got to the next page, I was like, let's try something new. I tried doing like a whole like 1 month on one page thing. So this is January, and the dates go from the 1st all the way to the 31st. This part of this was me being in Calgary, as well as being in China, I think. And so there's obviously some blanks, because when you're traveling, it's just hard to plan your day that way. And then I wrote down to-dos, I wrote down people I wanted to meet up with while I was visiting my hometown, and just like tried to create these little blobs, these little sections. And over time I saw which sections I would like to take up a whole page because I really need it and it's valuable, and which sections I like to just give them a small little area because they're not as useful to me. So then, oh whoa, we introduced one highlighter, it was pink. So I let myself have one black pen, one highlighter, and I continued just trying to figure out what types of layouts do I like with the bullet journal. And I was just truly experimentative. This was me trying to set up a shot list in my bullet journal. What else is going on here? Yeah, these are me like taking notes while I was like listening to a sermon. This is me when I was worried I was going to get bored on the airplane flying to China. So I made myself a long list of things I could do, including face mask, watch series of unfortunate event, fill in your customs card. Yeah, you can really go as detailed as you like, but that might have more been the outcome of me feeling like I'm trapped on a plane. I just need to find things that feel purposeful to do. And so I just went through it like that. Like when I was in China, I started making kind of like a little goal list for myself, because I was there for Chinese New Year, and it kind of felt like a really special time. It was my first time ever being in China for Chinese New Year. So I wrote goals like, one, hug all of my relatives. Two, take pictures or videos of all my favorite foods. Three, make sure in every city I at least once use a bike or local transit and just kind of get the feeling of the city at the ground level. Four, learn a new word a day. And here I am writing all the new Chinese characters that I learned. So it's so open. You really can do whatever you like. And I think for some that is intimidating, but for me, like, that's been the fun of bullet journaling, and I just don't worry too much about what other people are doing, and I just focus on, like, what seems to be working well for me, and I cut out the stuff that's taken up too much time or is, like, more stress than it's worth to, like, fill in the trackers. You know, there's a tracker that makes sense for you, and then there's just, like, a plethora of things that you could be doing. So that was what it's like in a dot grid. It's much easier to keep things organized. I do recommend a dot grid if you're just starting out. And then this Shinola is totally blank. So I even at one point brought in a post-it that had a grid to help me reintroduce some like visual order. But it really is all over the place. I have this like really cute printer. Where is it? I think it's nearby. That will like print pictures for you. And then you can peel off the backing to turn it into a sticker. So I use that as part of my outfit DIY planning process. Yeah, like, it's very flexible and open-ended. You can use it for a variety of things. I use mine for journaling, for planning projects, for planning my time. So I really do treat it as, like, an agenda and journal slash diary and a brainstorm notebook. I let this one book do all of those things for me just because I really like that they're all in one place. Alrighty. So let me get started with doing the layout for this. I keep all my bullet journal or just like reflection slash reading whatnot things all in one basket, and it's because sometimes this will take place right here at this table. Other times, if like we're watching TV or, you know, or if like I just happen to be at the kitchen bar, I might end up doing bullet journaling there. So I find the basket is a really good way to keep all of it in one place, and then you can be a bit more migratory with your approach. So this is where I keep a lot of my pens and whatnot. This is like a old greeting card box, and it has all of my zebra mouth liners inside. I try to give all of them equal love, even though it's not always the easiest. We all have our favorite colors, but today, in the name of equal love, I think the one I have not yet used yet in this bullet journal is brown. So we are whipping out the good old brown. It's like a nice little chocolate color. I actually really like that one. So that's where I keep my mouth liners, and if you haven't seen these before, these are really great because they're highlighters, but they're not neon, so they still let ink go through like regular writing ink to be visible, but they still have enough color. It's just like kind of right in the spot. There's one end that has a chiseled highlighter tip, and the other end is just like a regular little felt marker. So we're gonna go with the brown. This case right here is where I keep all of my usual, like, no matter what time it is, these are the bullet journal supplies I use. A Sharpie I don't really use in the bullet journal, but it's just good to have this nearby because it always ends up being that I need to draw on something with the Sharpie. Then the black pen that I use on the regular is the Muji 0.38 gel pen. I've got these two Tombow calligraphy markers. They're so hard to tell apart. That's my number one complaint if I had to give Tombow my feedback on this, especially in the dark. I'm like, I can't tell which one's navy and which one's black. But the navy one has a firmer tip, so its writing is a little bit thinner, whereas the black one has a softer tip. So it gives a little bit more of a brush appearance. And lastly, a little Muji mechanical pencil. That's useful for whenever I'm sketching or doing little markings, anything temporary. All right, there's a question. Oh, aren't you scared sometimes that when you're scheduling a professional meeting, someone might see your thoughts or anything personal that you would have wrote on the other page? Maybe. I would say that I very, very rarely whip out my notebook in a professional setting, so maybe that totally negates that fear in of itself. I also, I guess you may soon see, I have really small writing, and so that also just kind of overall reduces its visibility. But yeah, the number one thing that prevents that is that I only really have ever brought this out around friends. Like, if they share with me something and I want to make sure I don't forget, or like I keep it in my thoughts, I'll write that down, and I make sure that like my friends are comfortable with me writing that down in front of them and that kind of thing. So yeah, this is very personal. Like, I bring it out to a cafe. That might be the most outdoor exposure it gets. And I generally really do keep it to myself. So yeah, there's this. The other box I use, this is a box that used to hold some really tasty green teas from South Korea, Osoluk, if you're familiar with that Jeju tea, but now it just holds a whole bunch of pens. These colored pens that I use are Stabilos, and I really love them, Stabilo 0.88. I got the one that came in like a whole bunch of different colors, as you can see. So those ones have treated me really well. The other things in the mix here are these Crayola Take Note highlighters. They've got a highlighter on one end and like kind of a marker slash pen middle of the road on the other end. I've got these in a couple of colors and they're not bad. The one that's really fun, and whenever I bring this to like for other people to use, we can all take notes together and whatnot, is this one, the Crayola Take Note double-ended magic highlighter. It's so good. I'll give you a demonstration. So one end, obviously highlighter, the other end, what does this do? We will soon find out. So here I can highlight May. It's gonna be May, that's our month. And then with the clear end, if you make any mistakes, you just draw over it, gone. She is completely left the room, totally disappeared, which is like, I think the quality of the disappearing ink on these is amazing. They don't come in a ton of colors. I'll show you the ones that they come in. We got blue, purple, orange, yellow, and I believe there's one more. Pink. Oh wait, there's a turquoise too. I think I lent that one to a friend. Yeah. Well, I'm gonna take these out. And then, yeah, it's just a bit of a mishmash in here. But I tend to pull out a color that will match or coordinate with the highlighter that I've chosen, since we're going with this good old chocolate tone. Let's bring out this brown. Yeah, it'll be a nice and calm color palette for today. There's a question, is it a big difference to use dotted notebook versus lined? I worry mine would still be messy or ugly if I got a dotted one. If you find that you like to doodle and just have some freedom visually, I will say dot grid is so nice because it is subtle enough that it gives you that flexibility. Lined, I do end up finding that like the way I fill it very much follows the way the lines are. Like they instill order, and if you want order, then lined, and if you want some freedom, dot grid. That's what I would say about that. All right, I'm gonna put this back here in this basket, and I'm gonna bring these out too. This will be, if we have time, at the end, I will go through these bad boys. They're so good. Okay, so the first thing I do is like all about figuring out the spacing and trying to memorize. Yes, Julia's right. It's the HP Sprocket portable photo printer. That's the one I use to print my photos. Do I have it nearby? Found it. It looks like this. I think there is a newer version of this already, but if I can pop it open, there's some photo paper that goes in the very top. It just charges with this cord here and then connects to your device, usually your phone, wirelessly via Bluetooth. And then on the phone, you open up the app and pick the image that you want to print, and then it'll come out. Comes out on those little sheets that I showed you, and all of these little sheets have a removable backing that can turn them into a sticker, or you can keep it on and then you can like stick it on the fridge and all that kind of stuff to keep it as a photo. So yeah, I really love this for creative visualizing. Over time, it does slowly make your notebook like thicker because you're adding all these layers to it. But I don't know. I still feel like it's worth it because it's very fun. Okay, here we go. Normally, I'll do this. I find lately I do this in front of the TV. There'll be like a show playing in the background and I'll just get started with it. So the way I do my layout is I'll kind of draw this as my first marker. What is this? 1x4 squares in size. And then taking this one, I'll put in the MON for Monday. And then the hours that I break down go from 7 a.m. to 10 p.m. So we do 7 running all the way to 2 o'clock. And the only reason for that is because spatially, this is how I get it to work out right. And then I kind of will like peek over to see where this one is supposed to land. Continuing on from 3 o'clock all the way to 10 o'clock. And then now that's what Monday looks like. So I use that as a guide to continue moving down the entire section. And if you guys are just joining, welcome. This is our Sunday peaceful craft time. Every Sunday, today we're doing bullet journaling. If you want to listen to some background music, it's linked in the description. I got some nice choices for you, hopefully. And feel free to let us know what you are up to today. Okay, so I repeated this all the way down. I'm going to zoom in just ever so slightly so that you can see a bit better. Here we go. So we've got 7 a.m. to 2 p.m. multiple times, as in 5 times for the 5 days of the week. And then over here, we've got 3 till 10 p.m. And now that this has been spaced out, then I go backwards and I fill in the rest of the days of the week. With Tuesday next, then Wednesday. I've always thought Wednesday has such a funny spelling. Like if you really say it the way it's spelt, it's Wednesday. But in English, we're all like, no, Wednesday. It's kind of funny to me. All right, so there you are. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. We've got the first half of the day written down in terms of 7 to 2, and then I'll finish the rest of the 3 to 10s. I am definitely nervous that I'm gonna have that symptom where like if you're talking while you're writing, you end up writing the things that you're saying. So I do feel very like I'm trying to do one of these things right now. Yeah, so this is how I break down my day. It's because generally I just want like by 10 p.m. I should, if not be asleep, but be very on my way to going to sleep. And then 7 a.m. is kind of like a good time to wake up and still feel like you have a lot of time to take advantage of for the morning before it's noon. So that's how I structure it. Now, you'll notice that this and this still leaves kind of like an imbalanced amount of space over here. Over here, this is where I keep track of my to-dos. I find this really helpful because it can be a bit tiresome to keep little tasks and information locked up in your brain, and it's good to just write it down. It's there to remind you. You don't have to remember it and constantly think about it. To fill this in, I'll usually even fill them in according to the day of the week that I think I should be working on this. But the first step that I'll do is I'll flip back to the previous week, look at all the things that didn't get crossed off the week before, and transfer them over here. And there's, I think, just an element in bullet journaling of where the more you transfer the same thing, even though it can feel a bit defeatist that you haven't finished it yet. I do force myself to transfer it because it's kind of like forcing myself to eventually get sick and tired of transferring this to-do and just like get it done. So some of these to-dos, I have to admit, like I've been babysitting for a long time. But I still find going through the motion of transferring it is really helpful to finally be like, are you sick and tired of writing the same word over and over? Well then cross it off your list already. And I'll try to like space it to be equidistant from here. So what is an example? This is always the part of bullet journaling that's kind of awkward because I'm like, do I just write personal stuff here? Okay, for example, a friend of ours recently had a baby, just yesterday actually, which is super exciting. And so on my mind now is like, oh, should we organize some type of like meal delivery service to help them out? So since they just had their baby, I think I won't hit them with the information right off the top of Monday, but I will put the note on Wednesday to remind myself. So then, on Wednesday, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I'm gonna write meal train. I think that's the company that we'll use, like the online thing. Meal train for baby. Yeah, and then I just put it there on Wednesday. Once Wednesday comes, I'll look at the little to-dos that have accumulated for that day. I'll try to transfer them into the actual schedule so they have like a designated hour where it's my number one task and priority to get that one thing done. And then that's just how I try to like take something from the to-do, put it into the schedule. Once it's in the schedule, put it into action. It's so helpful on days where like the motivation is not as high, and yeah, just like going through those little steps helps you get things done. A lot of big things get done by you just taking the little steps over and over. Okay, so hello to everyone in the comments. Thank you so much for commenting. Okay, so that's what I'll do with my to-do list. Meal train for baby. Whatever that comes up, it'll go there. And then, oh yeah, the other thing is that I will look up in my schedule what types of appointments I have, and I'll put those in as well, since I do have to plan my tasks around the appointments. So I already know off the top of my head, there's a meeting that takes place every Tuesday morning for me. So I always put on Tuesday mornings this staff meeting in. And I admit the main reason this is all helpful to me is because I do suffer from time optimism, which maybe some of you will relate, is like the length of time that you believe it will take to get something done is not the same as the actual amount of time it will take to get something done. And I need these kinds of like visual reminders to myself of what is on the schedule so that I can snap out of the mentality that like, oh yeah, there's time, it'll be fine. Sorry, there's some comments about how the two cameras are not in sync, and I think that it really is the case, but yeah, in the last DIY that ended up actually being helpful because I found I would say something before you watch it happen, but if it's bothering you guys, we'll try to get it fixed for the next live stream. I'm so sorry. Okay, so I'll put in all of my appointments. Sometimes I even literally just put in like 12 o'clock noon, then make sure you eat lunch, because I can even fall behind schedule if I forget the fact that I have to eat food. Yeah, so it can just go like this, and you don't have to break down your bullet journal by any means by the hour. I only suggest it for myself because it helps me to break down my tasks into smaller pieces. And then everything that is left over here on the right hand side is that free space for me to journal. So let me give you a visual of how that all looks overall. Yeah, and like totally transparent, it doesn't always get filled in, and that's okay. Don't feel any stress that it has to be that way. So on the left side, as you can see, my weekly plans. Some days I just don't even feel like writing down a ton of things. I just know what I need to do and I just get started with it. and then all my journaling goes on the right. And then once in a while, I'll have like a series of notes to go through. So then I'll just have like a whole spread left blank for me to write down notes about various projects. And by the end of the week, it just kind of gets filled in that way. So I'll set up the Monday for you to see. It very much so mirrors what's going on the left. We'll put in the good old M-O-N. And in lieu of doodling, the main thing I do for fun is stickers. I keep all of them in this little zip pouch. This was actually a gift from Julia, who's helping to moderate the comments, and she got this embroidered at Muji, which is why it looks so nice. Thank you so much. I'll show you the stickers that I love and use often. There's kind of like two sections to this pouch, which is why it's also really nice for storing these stickers. In the past times, I would keep these stickers in that like back folding pouch that the Shinola and Moleskine's and Leuchtturm notebooks all have. Another downside of my current notebook, but that's okay. There's like a lot of cat stickers for some reason, but yeah, I just will have like lots of little doodads. Some of these I picked up when I was in Asia. Some of them I found in a store near me. I think I want to save this one for us to use this week. I also keep stamps in here because sometimes bullet journaling is when you realize you need to like write somebody a letter. And then there's like unopened sticker packages because I bought them because they were beautiful, but I still haven't had the guts to open them. Hope you can relate. This one's super cute, which is also why I'm paralyzed. It's because there are tiny flowers, which is already so great. But on top of that, they are nail art friendly. So I could either put them in my bullet journal or put them on my nails. And that's how I became paralyzed and never opened that package because that's way too nice. So those are some of my stickers that I'll keep on hand. I'm gonna progressively get more and more extra with the contents of this. I've got a cute little ruler. I think this one is from Muji. It only has centimeters, as in it's only metric and not imperial, which can be a bit of a downside for sewing, but in terms of drawing straight lines, obviously still great. I've got this like little retractable whiteout that I've truly had ever since I was in university studying and cramming for exams. So this one I really love because you know how it's so annoying how some whiteouts, like the whiteout tape will just get all disheveled in your pencil case. If any of you have owned whiteouts, I'm sure you know this feeling. So this one I really loved. I got it in university. It's made by Pilot and it's got a clicking retractable, so the whiteout tape is never disturbed. There's peace, and I think you can like pop it open to put in a refill as soon as it runs out. And this one has not run out ever since I graduated. So that's because we don't make mistakes. I'm just joking. It's just because it's a really great whiteout. So yeah, I love this one for its clicking abilities. And this last thing, the stationery store really tempted me and got me with this one. So I never thought I would come to this, but then I did. So if you've ever seen these little, I guess they're kind of like pre-cut washi tapes. If you've ever seen these little pre-cut washi tapes made by the company Kitta, let me show you one that's like might be more commonly found. Okay, this one. So then, and you'll open them and they have kind of a little booklet full of little tapes, and you can use those to create borders. You can use those to, like when you have a photo or some little receipt or something you want to affix to your bullet journal, you can use these as part of the stickiness to bring them down. Now, Kitta also sells a whole directory notebook where you can store multiple of their little stickers. So yeah, did I go for that? I did. So yeah, I just pick ones that look like natural and make me feel happy. This one's got like really pretty flowers and little fields. Let me peel one off just to show you what it's like. Let's go with the pink one. So yeah, just you can separate one really easily. It pops out. Then like I showed you here. This one's got a bit more of a like arts and crafts vibe, which I love. I'm really nerding out over stationery, so yeah, I'm sorry if this is not your cup of tea, just please bear with me. I love my stationery. Then this one has, the strips are like half width, so they're much skinnier, which is nice for their own separate reason. And this last one, ooh, this one's really different, which I love. They're wider than the usual one, and they have a very notes style. So sometimes when I learn something new that I really want to kind of like retain, I guess in a way it could be like a mantra or a quote, just something that really stood out to me or some even personal learning that I went through, I'll write it in big letters on here and put it into the bullet journal to kind of be like a sign that it's like, hey, don't forget this. You learned this. This was valuable. So those are the different ones that I keep inside this little Kita sticker display set. I'm not obsessed. And so yeah, let me show you this. This is the one that I picked out. It's got the pretty little flowers with a pink background. And I think you just kind of like dig at the corners a little to set it free. Yep. Here it comes. That's the backing. And then where should we put this? Let's put this right here. This will be its place. Do, do, do. Oh, okay. She in position. And there you have it. It's just a little sticker. It's semi-translucent. There's a little bit of see-throughness. That's one sticker I use often. Oh yeah, and I whipped these ones out because this is the other one. This is the reason why I have a pair of scissors in here. Oh, I got this in Japan at a stationery store and I lost it. I was so, so excited. So these come together. And I use this one every week as well because it helps me to keep track of how the days of the weeks land for that particular month. So this first one, it has the day of the month written in letters. Oop, I'll bring it a little bit closer for you. There's MTWTFSS, which is Monday to Sunday. In my mind, I let weeks start on Mondays, even though many treat Sunday as the first day of the week. For me, it's Monday. Oop. So I cut that free. And let's set this up in this bottom right corner. I'll kind of use the grid as a guide for this to land in the right place. So that's the header. And this is going to create the body of the calendar. Okay, so, oh my gosh, you guys. So this one, as you unpeel it, it just has days of the month. If you do some quick math, you'll see that every row is 7 higher than the previous row. So it's just like a finished, ready to go calendar. I'm gonna have to double check. So today is May 3rd. And it's a Sunday, which means May 4th will be a Monday. So because it's a new month, I do have to shift my cut. Like this here has the 6th on a Monday, which is, I believe, the way it was in April. So we're going to do a first cut to establish the 4th as the first day. Just put that over there. And then we will cut one more time before we get to the next number 4, since there will only be 1/4 per month. Okay. And then this one I just carefully tried to position underneath the headers. Oh gosh. Nope. Well, almost. All right, we're just gonna go with it. So yeah, these two pieces of tape, that's just what they do for me. They make me a tiny calendar in the corner of my bullet journal, but I really love it. And then I'll finish that off by using the highlighter and highlighting the week that we are in, which will be the week from the 4th to the 8th is the weekdays. And that's it. That's pretty much my whole month ready to go. I don't mean that I'm done, but I mean this is the spread. And then, oh yeah, there's one more secret pocket inside of this sticker thing. And inside the secret pocket is one last post-it that I really love. It's this little girl holding flowers. It says sweet flowers. There's a little grid on it. What company makes this? I can't tell. The label does say portable stick memo. And this is also a thing I do in lieu of doodling. I'll just like take out one sheet, set it aside somewhere. Let's put it in the upper right corner. And what I do with this special little sheet is I use it as a place to write down just like people that I'm thinking of, circumstances, friends who are going through like a hard time or anything like that. I admit I am bad at storing that info in my mind, and I don't want to come off as a person who's forgetful. So what I do is I try to set myself up for success, and I'll designate this as a place to write down people I'm thinking of. Just like if they're, I don't know, like it's a bit sad, but the reality is in real life, like people are going through hard stuff. Like they're going through like challenging relationships, sickness in the family, financial stress. There's a lot of different things, and I want to like look out for those people and keep them in mind if I know that's happening. So I'll write that down right there. And from past months, you can see this little sticker helping me out with keeping track of some names and circumstances. So that's what I do. This is just truly like my way of trying to be like good for myself as well as good for the people around me. And then over the course of the week, I will fill all excess space with these little kitty cats because whatever, they're really cute. Okay, I'll show you one more thing that I use for my bullet journaling. And I think then we will wrap up our time here. I'm so sorry, I don't think I've done a really great job answering questions today. So if you guys wanna quickly put a couple of questions in here while I show you this last thing, I will take a look at the questions and get a look at that. Okay. Ooh. All right, guys. So this last thing that I want to show you is my fashionery stationery. I did mention this in the latest video that went up yesterday, but I wanted to give you a bit more of like a close-up demonstration of how I use this. So whenever I'm planning for a sewing project, these are the two notebooks that might come into play, and they're sold on fashionery.org. I've had these for, I don't know, a couple years now. Let me get out my colored pens. All right. And what I do with these is they're different from each other. So this red notebook, it contains super, super faint outlines of a women's form. And then there's also a version of this that you can buy that has a male form as well as larger notebooks. This one's kind of on the, it's on the medium end, I guess. And so I'll use these to help me draw fashion designs because I'm not that good at the sketching part, but having the dotted lines to follow just gives me the freedom to focus on the outfit instead of the actual, the proportions and just trying to make this person, I don't know, resemble a human at this point. What I'll do is, this is not how it was meant to be done, but it's just because I like consolidating everything inside my actual bullet journal, is I'll take one page, score, and fold, and I'll tear it out. This is like good old practice from origami days, trying to do a straight riff on live camera. Oh, Okay. So I'll bring out one of these. And then this other notebook has a different type of dotted lines. So it's got this little like accordion folded sheet. I'll just try to extract one of them. There's a couple in here. And this one, the faint dotted line it has is the faint dotted line of an upper half body, as well as on its flip side, the faint dotted lines of the lower half. And it's got lines on it to indicate like the hip height, the waist height, the knee height. It just helps you visualize like whether you're trying to draw pants or a midi skirt, little shorts, like you'll know what's the right time for them to start and end time. What's the right point on the body to start and end. So let me tear out one of these as well. These ones are perforated, so they're a little bit easier. But hopefully I'm not speaking too soon. Hey. So those are the two that I will bring out. And yeah, let me just do like a pretend sketch. I can draw the outfit that I'm wearing today. It's not elaborate, trust. I'll bring out some pens to prepare it. This is like the peachy one of the Stabilo, so I'll use that for my skin. And then there's black. Always use that for my hair. Whenever I'm drawing white outfits, I'll tend to use like a medium or light gray to kind of substitute as white. And surprise, surprise, I'm just like wearing black leggings. So the way this will go is I'm gonna zoom in a little bit so that you can see. All right, I'm gonna answer a couple of questions while the two cameras catch up a little bit. Where do I buy my stationery? So a lot of the stationery that I showed today actually is purchased from a store that's in my neighborhood, and the store is called Paper Plus Cloth. I really love it. They specialize a lot in some more Japanese brands, I would say. So if that interests you, there's definitely a bit more of like a Japanese or kind of like Asian flavor in that stationery store. One that has like even more of a Asian flavor that I love is Hanji, which is also in Toronto. I think Hanji has like a couple of locations. And then the other store I'll visit a lot is The Paper Place, which is in Queen West. It's a really big store with a lot of really pretty stationery. So if you're in Queen West, feel free to DM me anytime and I'll send you my list of my favorite stationery stores. All of those stores do also sell online. I know for sure Paper Plus Cloth does sell online. Stationery is a great thing to buy online because it's like pretty self-explanatory from the photo what it is. So I don't mind buying stationery online. And I also, as you saw, some of these are from like when I went to Japan 3 years ago, and I love stationery, but I somehow have some weird gift of making it last a long time, even though I'm using it so much. I don't know what it is. It's like I ration it and I love it at the same time. It's confusing. But yeah, that's most of the places that I get my stationery. I'm gonna get started with drawing and I'll try to answer some more questions. I try not to draw like the skin because I focus on the clothing first, since the clothing is on the outside and you can't, in most cases, see the skin through the clothes. So in this case, I'm going to start with a t-shirt, which is why I'm starting with the gray. I think you guys can see this. Yeah, should be good. So we'll just draw the neckline, and according to how gravity is, generally clothing touches the surface of the skin on any top surfaces, and then once it peters off any cliff edges, that's when it kind of like takes on a little bit of its own shape. So I'll follow the dotted lines across the top, and then once I come around the shoulder, I'll just let it hang, and then I'll cut across. I'll do the same on the other one. What this really helps me with, this whole drawing exercise, is especially when I'm copying or trying to just like look at how a garment is constructed, I'll force myself to draw every single seam on the drawing, and that really helps me to see things I didn't notice before, like, oh, that's how they did the hem on the end of the sleeve, or that's how they did the collar. Without it, I find I just think about the shape, but once I actually have to draw every seam, then you see all the little details. So for example, this one has a separate collar here. So if we were being really accurate, we would draw that in. And then it's got like a little hem on the ends of the sleeves, so we can draw that in if we want to. And then I just follow the rest of the body form that they've provided. This t-shirt that I'm wearing pretty much goes to my hips. And then we'll cut across here. And I'm just wearing leggings, so I will draw that.
Do you have something thicker? Because people can't see.
They cannot?
No, they can't.
Oh, man.
You can see it on the computer, but
for some reason, they can't see. I'm gonna zoom in even more. I'm so sorry, you guys. I'll bring it in close so you can see the dotted lines in a moment. Yeah, I'm not freehanding this. I truly am just following the dotted lines, I guess. It's convenient that I'm wearing leggings because that is the greatest excuse to just follow the lines. So yeah, there's the bottom. And then after I'm done that, that's when I let myself draw the arms and all the other things that are showing through the clothes because now I know that they won't be in the way of where I'm supposed to draw clothes. So there's one hand, and I'm truly just following the dotted lines that this provides. Two hands. I'll zoom in a little bit and hold it here so you can see the dotted lines. There's a question, how do I keep all my stationery pens so organized? As a pen hoarder, I have difficulty storing so many pens. I relate. How do I keep it organized? I think this whole like box system of mine works really well. Like all my mild liners go in this box, and this is a box that I kept left over from some greeting cards. And then all of my drawing pens go in this box, which is a box from some tees that I used to have. So I highly recommend separating them into different zip pouches or different boxes and that kind of thing. Okay, so then here she even has feet outlined, so you can draw those too. And then this now gives me room to come up here and draw the neck. I always just draw the lower half of the face plus the two little ears that they provide, and it's because I am not bald, so I just draw the lower half. And then I fill in the upper half with some, I don't know, my best attempts of trying to draw what hair looks like. And so yeah, this is now a self-portrait that I whipped together really quickly. And the dotted lines that come in these notebooks seriously help so much. So that's what this one provides for me. And I might like trim the top and then tape it into the notebook. Let me try to find a good example of how this has looked in the past. Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, here's a great example. Okay. So, for example, this was the whole game plan that I drew when I was planning to sew the Cicely Bonson inspired quilted satin wrap coat. So I'll put like a title, you know, just declare it, declare your project. And then here is a tear out from that notebook. It's the exact same like size and proportions as this drawing that I just did because it's the same dotted figure. But yeah, I through that drew all the things that I needed to focus on for this coat. I made sure I drew that there was piping along the shoulders, and there was piping here where the body joins with the sleeves. Then there's piping again at the cuffs. All those little details helped me to notice those steps that I would have to take. I've got the wrap in the front, and then I add little numbers to remind myself of measurements. And down here, I was just not in the mood to draw any fancy pants or shoes, so it just became scribbles, but I feel like it still gets the point across. And then from there, like I drew the dimensions of the original blanket that I was working on that I used to thrift into this coat. I wrote down some dimensions of this green army shell liner I had, which I was going to use to model the proportions of the jacket as well. So that took over this half of the page. And then the other half of the page, I used this other guide that came from this gray thing. So let me try to hold it up a little closer so you can see. But there are these faint orange dots that give you kind of the outline of an upper body. And so I followed those dots. In this case, I purposefully drew the back of the coat because in the full body drawing, I had the front. So I just thought I might as well try to visualize the back. I drew the diamond pattern to remind myself which direction the diamonds are supposed to go, added where I plan to put the ribbons, and like all the piping details that are all across the entire coat, as well as a reminder to myself to never forget the pockets. So using those dot items from Fashionery has helped me a lot with just like drawing well. And then this is a printed photograph from my little HP sprocket. And the last little thing I have here, it's like a pop-up book, is this is just like a little grid post-it that I have. And I used this. You see how this shape roughly matches this? It's because the goal of this drawing was to provide for myself a layout plan of how I was going to chop the blanket into the individual pieces that would make up this coat. So it was like the body pieces are gonna have to come from this corner. This blue diagonal was the bias tape, which has to be cut on a diagonal, so it does end up taking up a lot of space when you're cutting it out of a material. These pink pieces were the sleeves. This purple down here was the back, and these three green rectangles were going to become the skirt. So that's how I use my Fashionery tools to plan for a sewing project. And I know visually it looks like a lot, but it honestly is even harder to imagine if I'm just trying to picture it in my brain. When I draw it out like this, it gives me a game plan. And from there, you can start tackling the project. So that's how I put all of that together. And yeah. Thank you all so much for bullet journaling with me. I hope you enjoyed fawning over my stationery as much as I do. And yeah, if you want to come back and watch these again with us in the future, do not forget to subscribe. And don't forget to hit the bell notification. That way you'll get notified when we go live. If you'd like, you can find me on Instagram at withwendy. I also do announce these live streams over there, as well as polls for us to pick when we're going, or not when, but what topic we will do in the next live stream. So please do let me know if there's a topic that you'd love for us to cover. And I think that will be it for us today. Thank you all so much for tuning in, and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.